We're about to meet the Belgium supermum who has learned to look after herself and her daughter with just her feet. 39-year-old Sarah Talby was born with no arms and has learned to cook, clean and dress not only herself, but her 3-year-old daughter, Lilia.
Oh, it's a beautiful story, yeah. The artist and YouTube sensation can also paint, do her own hair and makeup and work, among other things. Now she's on a mission to show the world how she manages motherhood. Sarah Talby joins us via Zoom from Brussels in Belgium. Supermom Sarah, thank you so much for taking the time for us today and welcome to Studio 10. Now, you were born with no upper limbs. Can you take us through how you first learned to use your feet to do everything as a child?
Actually, I did it just like you did with your hands and with your arms. So it's not about a learning or something I had to learn. It's really intuitive. It's really natural. I think the brain is really strong and just fulfilled the emptiness that nature gave.
It's just so fascinating. Now, I read that you can do your own makeup and change your bra without arms. I mean, how do you do that? Tell us about it.
I think I could just ask you the same question. How do you do it? It's really the same. Like, the brain is fascinating because it's, for me, it's natural. So I really don't have any tips to give. It's so intuitive, it's so natural. I just do it like any woman would do it. And as I was born this way, I think it's more natural than if I would have lost my limbs during life.
Well, I tell you what's not natural is putting me in a kitchen and cooking, because I am absolutely terrible at it, but your cooking seems to be fantastic. No doubt, like all of us when we're learning, you must have had some mishaps in the kitchen.
Yes, but this I never show. It's on YouTube.
Yeah, for sure.
And what does your toddler Lilia think of everything?
Yeah, of course. But cooking is just, I mean, I just cook to eat every day, and it's not like I'm not going to open any restaurant so far. Yes, it's sometimes it can be a mess up, but so far so good.
Have you come across anything that you just refuse to attempt or to try to do? I mean, obviously there's dangers in everything, just like all of us. But is there anything that holds you back?
Yes, I have some caution for the oven. Do you say that?
The oven?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Because I'm afraid to burn myself or to burn my feet. And yes, this is something I just take caution about it. But otherwise, no. I think I never feel any danger or something.
No. That's great to hear. So tell us about the... I was reading also that the doctors can't really explain why you were born with no arms. What happened there?
Yeah, so when I was like in my mom's belly, let's say, the fetus I was didn't develop the limbs, the upper limbs. And this so far don't have any explanation. So doctors don't have any explanation. Like, we don't have explanation about a lot of disease, like autism, like a lot of things still remain without explanation. I think nature does things, and it is this way. And so far, we don't have any explanation about that.
We touched on it just before there. You have a little girl, Lilia. How's Lilia? What does she think about her super mom? And how do you navigate Lilia through how you cross the road and stuff?
I think Lilia doesn't think she has a super mom, and this is what it's amazing with a child. Children just think that this is normal, and people have arms, other people don't have arms, and she thinks that I just don't have arms, like some people are short, tall, thin, fat. That's it's just a detail for her. So maybe when she will grow, she will realize that it is a disability. But so far, she just thinks that a lot of people are different, and some people have arms and others don't. Mm.
That's beautiful. Sarah, you've racked up over 300,000 subscribers on YouTube. Why did you start documenting your journey of motherhood?
Actually, I began documenting my journey as an artist because I paint, and I paint with my feet. So a lot of people ask me questions like, you paint with your feet, but can you cook? Can you do that? Can you do this? Can you dress? And when I responded, people didn't believe me. So I thought, okay, I will respond through videos, and maybe people could imagine that, because I totally understand that some things I can explain difficult to imagine. And this is how I began. And also with the first lockdown, a lot of people were on internet, so it was also a kind of activity to face the lockdown. And it's amazing today I have subscribers and I still cannot believe it.
Well, it is amazing, and you are amazing, and it's such an inspirational story. It's such a pleasure to get to speak to you today. You're doing such a fantastic job. Lillian must be very proud of you. Thank you so much for joining us today. We really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me. Thank you very much. Thank you.